Drag the ordered pair to the correct quadrant. With a problem like this, I always like to have a coordinate grid handy. So if you have some graph paper, go ahead and use it. If you don't, you can just do a little sketch on a piece of notebook paper. But you want to go ahead and draw an x and y axis and get ready to plot some points. So on the coordinate grid, I'm going to go ahead and label the quadrants. Here's quadrant 1. It's quadrant 2. Quadrant 3. Quadrant 4. Let's go ahead and plot the points to see what quadrant they're in. The first point is 4, 4. So I'm going to start at 0, 0, and it's 4 for the x, 1, 2, 3, 4 to the right, and then 4 for the y, which means 4 up, 1, 2, 3, 4, right there. And that one is 4, 4. The next coordinate, negative 2.2. And then negative 4.1. Negative 2.2 means negative 2.2 to the left, so about right there. And then negative 4.1 means 4.1 down, so 1, 2, 3, 4.1. Just going to estimate, and that's negative 2.2, negative 4.1. The next coordinate, 3, negative 6. 1, 2, 3 to the right, and then negative 6 means 6 down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, just right here. And that's 3, negative 6. And then the fourth point, negative 2.5 for the x and 4 for the y. So start at 0, 0. Negative 2.5 for the x means 2 to the left. And then 4 up, 1, 2, 3, 4, right there. And that is negative 2.5, comma 4. Now that the points are plotted, we can easily see which quadrants they belong in. 4, 4 is in quadrant 1. Negative 2.2, negative 4.1, that's in quadrant 3. It's down here. 3, negative 6, that's in quadrant 4. And negative 2.5, 4, that one is in quadrant 2.